complete and optimal. That four things we checked, and from that we found out the space complexity, whose space complexity is better, depth first search, space complexity. Space complexity, which one is better? Depth first. Space complexity, not the time complexity, because you just need to remember kind of only one path. So it was in the order of big O B M. Right? Remember? Good. And then we stopped there. Depth first search, we have shown you the algorithm. Let's proceed further. Then depth first search we covered, breadth first search we covered, and there we stopped. And then we said which one is better based on different things, different answer can come, and then we stopped here. So we'll start from here right now today. Okay. So you have to tell me the answer, which search is this? So the run would be on a Pac-Man, or not a Pac-Man, but a maze. The black is the obstructions, and this guy tried to find out the destination here. So G, this is the green is the goal state, and the red is, sorry, the green is the start state and red is the goal state. I'm running it once again. So which search strategy is this? Breadth first or depth first? How many for breadth first? Raise your hand. BFS. How many for BFS? How many for DFS? So, okay, what is the question? The question is, I'm stopping here. So this is a maze. This is, so the agent is starting from here and its target is to going there. It cannot go through these black things the obstacles. Now it wants to find out how it can reach this. So right now we have learned two algorithms. One is the BFS, breadth first. So I'm writing the word B. And another is the depth first, D. So you have to answer which search is been performed here. And how will you know? Just by seeing the dots. Whenever I'm adding the dot, that means this path are been explored. So why new things are like, these are the path it is discovering or it is adding to the fringe. So how many for BFS? How many for DFS? Huh? I'll show, but from this information itself, it should be kind of obvious. So BFS, how many for BFS? Okay, I'll say 15. Okay, or 12. How many for DFS? 5. So BFS is the winner, and in fact it is the BFS. Breadth first. Why? Because you can see that the spread is kind of gradual. Depth, what happens? It just goes through some path. We'll come there later. Okay. So this is one. So breadth first, because it kind of gradually exposed. Breadth first, that's what it does, right? It does not just follow a particular path. Oh, this path is nice, I'll follow that. It just kind of spreads through. All the path which is like two steps ahead, it will find out all the path, then go to three, then four, then five, all those things. Okay? That is the breadth first. For the depth first, what is happening? This is the depth first, and you can see, and you can understand what is going on. Followed it? Like, okay, it is just following some path, like, and then it backtracked and then found another path. But see one thing, it never came at this side. Why? So? Come again? Not hearing you. So it finds the subject.
Subtree.
And then? subtree itself. So at the beginning, you don't know where is the goal state, right? You are just exploring. Why this thing did not come here? Exactly, that is the answer. It could, but you, at this point, you could might have tried to explore this part first and very last this. It could happen. The algorithm is like that. It is trying to go to the left first. From any point, it is trying to go to the left first. So it could happen that this is the very last node that would got exposed. You will just finish all this path, and then at the end, you finish find that path. That could happen. Okay, clear? Depth first, breadth first. Good, and this is the pathfinding algorithm. Now we'll go in the middle zone, which is the iterative depending. So right now we find out that one thing is better than the other. We found out. So we found out which one is better, breadth first or depth first. Usually, breadth first. Breadth first is better. But it has one issue. What is that main con? For one reason, it is worse than the depth first. What is that? Space. It takes plenty of space. So now the question is, can I then solve this thing in a way so that it will be as good as our depth first, breadth first, but it don't take much space. That is the idea. Kind of getting the good thing about both these things together. So taking the good thing from the B and good thing from the, so this is the con for breadth first, while for the depth first. Process space, and the con is kind of the con is time, and for this the process time. Okay. Now our idea is, okay, no compromise. We want to get the best of both worlds. So we want kind of time of this guy and space of this guy. Okay, time of this guy and space of that guy, that is the target. Following question, so the pros and cons part is clear. Yes, good. So we'll then continue with this. How can I put these two things together? And the solution, whatever I will tell you, it may look like a stupid solution, and we'll say, oh, why will I do that much work? But actually, it will work very good. The idea here is called the iterative depending. That means you are going to do the depth first search, but every time you do the search, it would be depth limited. Probably this is one algorithm which you have not, none of you have learned earlier. Is it true? So we'll tell what is the strategy and how is it coming. But let's see, the idea here is, you are going to go gradually. At the very beginning, you want to make, you search a tree for depth 1. Search it. If you find the goal, very good. If not, then you will search the tree, start totally again from for a tree of depth 2. Then depth 3, then depth 4. So what I'm doing it, so I'm kind of going from 1, so depth 1, depth 2, depth 3, depth 4, This tree may have many length, but I'm not going further. So 1, 2, 3, 4, every time depth 5. And for each of these, for the depth 1 and depth 2 and depth 3, all I'm going to do is, I'm going to do a depth first search until I'm finding the solution. DFS. See, at the beginning, you are forgetting about whatever down thing you have. You are just concerning the top level, like depth 1. And whatever you have, you just look into that. So, let me recall. Okay. So, run a DFS with the depth limit of 1. You forget about whatever is there below that. You do not need to remember or know or whatever. The solution might be here. You don't care. You just search here. If it fails, then you do the same DFS again from the beginning, but this time run a DFS with the depth limit 2. So every time you are doing a DFS, but you are kind of limiting the depth, and you are continuing it again and again and again and again. Yes. Why am I doing it? Beginning, because otherwise how will you do? If you keep track, then things would be complicated, because see, remember, all you want is the process of the space. Because I know that whatever depth it is, if I start from the beginning, everything would be easy for me, because I do not need to remember what happens other places. You cannot start from the depth, that particular depth. You need to always start from the beginning, and we will see that if you do that, our big O notation, it is kind of the trickery of the big O notation, that you are not going to lose anything. I'll explain why is that. Why this algorithm is good enough. In the worst case, the algorithm will take twice the time. The algorithm will take twice the time, and 2 multiplying any time by 2 in big O notation, we don't care, right? If an algorithm takes 1 minute, we don't care if it is taking 2 minutes. Just a constant, multiplying it by constant. That we will see that why is that it is going to achieve that one. Now, what is the question? No. It is not going one step down and doing the breadth first. It is doing a depth first search, but you are limiting the depth. At a time you are first doing run a DFS with depth limit 1, so you are not looking anything here, then next time you are doing a DFS on this, and then continuing in this way. So DFS, we already have learned what is the advantage here. So at the okay, let's continue. Actually, I'll show you. So next, run a DFS with depth limit 3, and probably there you found it. Now it looks like, right, it is very wasteful. Why I am doing the same thing again and again? One answer I can always tell, that okay, at which level I got the solution? If I had to just do the DFS, I need to traverse this whole path. Now I am not doing that. Good, right? But now the question can come, okay, I could just directly search for a DFS with depth limit 3. I would find the solution. Right? What is the difference between a DFS and this? Because this is a DFS, that is the difference, that is a very core difference. No, that is exactly the difference, right? That is the difference between the BFS and DFS. Then the BFS, you will explore this and then explore this and explore this. And what is the issue there? The space complexity was huge. You need to remember everything there. For which one? To that, yes. We already know. See, DFS, there should not be any question that, okay, what is that, what is the space complexity? For this one, if this if you find the solution at the level S, then it is BS, big O of BS. okay? And what is the time complexity? Now, okay, now actually let's see what is going on and why this is not wasteful, or if it is wasteful or not. So, okay, I am asking the question, I could just do a BFS with the depth limit, that particular depth limit, would it be better? No, because the same thing, the space complexity would come in. Now, what would be the time complexity and the space complexity of this program, this problem? What would be the time complexity and space complexity of this problem, of this solution? So, actually I will ask you work out this one and then we will discuss. Work it out. Not the solution, right? Surendu, get some paper. It is easier to think right when you are writing. See, you can find the solution at any level, any depth. Probably you are finding the solution at the depth S. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, continuing in this way. So, do the math and show me. Yeah, sir, show me. What would be the time? Depth first search could be, so whatever the depth first search do, that's the same thing we will do. Yeah. You know how does the depth first search work, right? No, if you have only this much, then what will you do at the level 1? Then what will you do? B. So as you can see, that the branching factor is B. And you can assume that you will find the solution at the level, at the depth S. The space is bm, okay, big of bm, no, not, it is not, what is the m, what is the m, final depth, you do not need, you need to see, it is, you can just assume whatever you are going through the depth, right, the s, so you can assume that the s level you are finding the solution, at the level s, at the depth s you are finding the solution. So we are just trying to find out the space complexity and the time complexity. Talking about the BFS or DFS?
BFS.
Yes. For BFS, no, BFS we try to go down.
For DFS
we go down, and you are talking of BFS. BFS is right, we go one level with the other. Okay, I'll tell you. I'm just telling another thing. Okay, so I'll go there, but just to answer one of the questions, so I'm just making sure both of you got the idea of the DFS and BFS, just not the iterative depending, but for the DFS and BFS, and you can always assume that the node you are exploring from the left to right. What would be the answer for DFS or not would be the answer for BFS if you traverse this thing? Just traversing, probably your goal is finding the 7. So whatever be the algorithm, DFS or BFS, you will find the 7 at the last. So, what would be the order of exploring? What would be the order of exploring the nodes? From left to right, yes. No, write it down and then tell me. Write it down first. All of you, please write it down. This very simple one, right? Write it down on paper. Write it down. Just the order of the nodes, the way you are exploring. For this one, we will come first do this one. Keep that, hold on to that answer, we will just come there. But before that, I am just making sure all of you are getting the DFS and BFS correct. So, who will tell me the answer? Or you need more time? Let me see how is thing going. So I'll explain that part too. Let's see. That is a good point. So I'll just getting out of following or not. Okay. Have you got the other answer? This answer to this. BFS and DFS for this tree, going from the left to right. Write it down the sequence. Which one? For this question? For this BFS DFS? Just the node explorer you are exploring. No, we'll go there later because apparently there are people are having some doubt with this thing itself. So write down the answer first for this question. Have you written down? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Good. How are you doing? For this one you have done? No, it doesn't. No, do it for this one. I just want to make sure that.
So BFS, BF. Searching will be used. BFS we can use.
5, 3, 6, 7.
Good. No, put it on to be written. Okay, keep it. Good. Okay. We'll come there. Okay. So let me actually write down the answer for DFS and BFS. For BFS, it is very straightforward because you are going by level 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. For BFS, what is the answer? And I am not sure if you are following the BFS part or not, how this is working, because I am getting multiple answers from different of you. So I will just go through. So you, at the very beginning, you see the 1, and then you see, okay, from the 1 I can go to the 2 and 3. So 1, 2 or 1, 3. So this thing, actually the easier way of writing is, you could just write 1 and then you are getting the 2 and 3. You are writing, but you are exploring right now 2 only. Or how can I tell actually? Actually, I'll just tell you the exactly what is going on. 1, you got the 1, and then you found out you have 2 and 3, 2 the different way. So you just, right now you want to go to the left. So you just go to the, put the 2, don't consider the 3. That is one way, actually. Which way I should tell you actually? So let's talk about this way directly. So 1, and from there you go to the 2, and from the 2 you go to the 4, and you found out 4 is not the goal because I am looking for 7. So you go back to 2 and then come right, and 5 is not also the goal state. You go back to 2, you go back to 1, then the left side is done, then you come to the right hand side. So very first thing you are exploring is 3, and from there again I will try to go to the left, 6, and then that is not the goal state, then 7. I can write it down in this way. That is one way of writing. Another way of writing is having something called a stack or queue. Stack. So if I have a stack, then how I do is I put the 1 into the stack, okay, and then what I do? Pop it from the stack. So this is my stack and this is my traversal. I am just writing the traversal. Pop 1 from the stack. Put all of its child, like from 1 where you can go, 2 and 3. But for this example, we need to do the 2 and 3 in the reverse way because we always want to take out the left hand thing first. So I'll just, 1 I'm taking out, putting it there, and I'm putting 3 and 2. Because the stack always, the element we take it out is from the top, and you can think this is the top. Stack, all of you know stack, right? Stack? Confused look, why? Stack, you know, all of you? What is the stack? What is the stack? No, let's BDA, first BDA. What is the stack? Huh? No, what is the stack? Or not first and last. Is that a stack? No, it is not a stack. What is the stack? What is a stack usually? Tell me actually, just give me an example. One thing I'm putting, that is a stack. Stack is an everyday word, right? We use a stack of books. Stack of books, pile of books, whatever, stack of plates, whatever, right? That is the stack. Collection, but what is it is important because whatever things usually you put first, the top thing, that is the thing you take out first. Last in, first out. Whatever thing you are putting last, you are taking out first. So that comes secondary, that is the data structure thing, but a stack is a kind of a pile. If you have a pile of book, how difficult would it be to take out the very last, the down book, the book that is at bottom? Very hard. Easiest is the top one. So that is what you do. And for making sure that we always take out the left hand side thing first, I'm just putting it in a different order, 3 and 2. And next time then what I have to do? I have to take out one element. Every time I'll take out one element and I'll put something here. From there, whatever I'm taking out, put it here and add something new to the stack. That is the idea, very basic idea. Probably all of you are learning stack, or probably all of you know, right? First year? You should know, CS. And BD also you know stack. Somewhere you have studied? Yes? So what would happen next? This tool would come here. And I'm going to put. What should I put here in that? Huh? 5 and 4. This 5 and 4, the ordering we need to switch, because whenever I am taking out, I want to take out the left thing first. So next time what should I do? Huh? I'll take out 4. Should I put anything here? No. And 4 is not a goal state, so I'll continue. Next, what will I take out? 5. Are you following it? 5. 5 is not a goal state, continue. Then what will I take out? I'm not putting anything because there is nothing to put. The 5, there is nothing below. If there were something, I would put that. Then I take out the 3, put it here. Now for the 3, should I do something else? Whenever I'm taking out 3, I need to see if I have something to the left and right, I need to put them. What I should put here? 7 and 6. And next time, what should I take out? 6. 6 does not have a child, done, then 7. So remove 6 and last is 7. So this is another way of doing it, using the literally stack, pushing, popping and everything. Okay? And finally, another way, last time we have shown, it is a little bit longer way, but for sometime it is easier for understanding. So from 1 you can go 2 and 3. And next time you just remember, okay, the 2 is the thing that has come first. So from the 2 you can go 1, 2, 4 and 1, 2, 5. And from the 4 you cannot go anywhere, from 5 you cannot go anywhere, then from the 3. So okay, when I'm getting the 2, I'm cutting that. Then 1 and 3, from 1 and 3 where can you go? 1 and 3, 1, 2, 3, you can go 1, 3, 6, 1, 3. 7. Right? And from there you cannot go anywhere, so you can cut these things too. I'll do it once again. Well, it's not very clear. So what is the advantage of writing in this way? This won't be make sense if the tree is very big, because your list would be quite long. Kind of the redundant information. So 1, you cut the 1 and put 1, 2, 1, 3. Then you cut the 1, 2, put 1, 2, 4, 1, 2, 5, and then you cut the 1 to 4, nothing. Then you cut this 1 to 5, nothing. Then 1, 3, you cut this guy and put 1, 3, 6, and then you cannot do, and 1, 3, 7. Cut this, and then whenever you are taking this out, that time you are finding that you had a 7 there. Okay, the same thing. So I am spending some time for our next Thursday's quiz. I am just going to ask you questions on the BFS and DFS. It would be a very simple quiz. Okay? Because I did not teach anything else except that last week. So nothing from today's class would come anyway. So this thing won't be the part. Now going back here. So okay, we got the idea how the BFS and DFS are different. even a two layer, the question you are asking, I don't know why you are asking without writing. That's why I'm emphasis every time. Don't think. I know that you can think, but write it down. When I'm asking that, write it down, write it down. Okay? That is very important. Okay, so BFS and DFS. DFS, what is the solution I got? 1, 2, 4, 5, 3, 6, 7. So we can see that even for depth 2, these two things are different. BFS, DFS are different. Now we are talking about the iterative depending, how this thing works. What algorithm it works? So as per the question here, as you can see, right? That the algorithms are different, doesn't matter it is a depth 2 or 3. Even if it is depth 2, the tree is getting different. Okay? Okay, now who came up with the answer? For this iterative depending, I asked you long back, probably 10 minutes back, what is the time complexity, what is the space complexity? Provided the branching factor is B and the solution you are finding at depth S. Using this solution, iterative depending. Tell me the answer. First, tell me the answer, then we'll discuss. Okay, space complexity. Who wants to tell me? Space complexity would be? Big of? BS. Any other answer? Everyone is happy with the answer? No other answer? Good. So this is the correct answer. Good. Time complexity. B to the power S. Okay. Any other answer? The log is coming. I'll actually told you. So this is kind of the actual answer, but I will explain why this is the answer. Okay. So let's not write the big O of BS, or we can write it down. But just saying simply, when the depth is zero, how much time would it take to do the search? There is no 2 here, branching factor is B, no 2, so 1. When the depth is 1, that means you have B number of child. What is the time it is going to take? B. When the depth is 2, that time? B square, very good. And in this way, when it is the depth S where you are finding the solution, so in this way it is keep on increasing. And when at the depth S, when you found out the solution that time, how many nodes you need to search? B to the power S. Okay, just for completing, what would be the earlier layer? The S minus 1 layer, how many nodes are there? B to the power S minus 1. Okay? No, you are not searching. Okay, good point. So that is very good point. So you are searching actually B square. So actually, all you are doing is actually right. That is actually perfect. That would actually make the answer correct. But if you know from the big O notation itself, you know that this thing is. No, B S minus 1, but this thing is less than B to the power S. Right? That means this whole thing is kind of less than 2 b to the b go b to the power s, and constant doesn't matter, so it is in the order of b to the power s. So yes, you are doing something extra, but as most of the nodes are coming at the very last level, the cost is less. Cost is not that significant. Clear? So why the advantage is coming? Because most, whenever we do the search, most of the work is actually done at the very last level, or the level you are finding the solution. Because every other levels the nodes are quite less. It is again this idea of the chessboard thing. The way further you go into that rise, putting the rise thing, the bigger it becomes. The number of rice grains you put in that particular square is kind of the sum total of all other rice you have put until now. Right? So the only the dominating factor is b to the power s. So we found out this algorithm. The space complexity is big O of bs, and time complexity is big O of b to the power s. The best we could have expected. Right, the space complexity is kind of the same thing that we have found for the depth first search usual, and even less because we have the S here. And the time complexity is the best anyway that we could get. Okay? Time complexity or space complexity? Space complexity is the, see, space complexity, what is happening? So space complexity, the idea is the same. Whenever the depth is zero, that time how many nodes you need to, what is the space complexity you need? 1. And next time, big O B actually, because, sorry, big O, big O B, right? How is that? So you just need to remember all the paths, so B. From the this one you are going to this path and you are remembering all others. Space complexity I am talking about, right? So okay, actually I will just put it in simply, so we do not need to spend much time. So space complexity would be the maximum whenever you are at the level s. Every time you are doing it from scratch. So if I just find out the space complexity that a depth first search take at depth s, what is that? Big O bs. And every other time complexity is less than that because they're obvious. And every time I'm not keeping any other information, I'm doing it from scratch. So it doesn't matter what are those. Okay? So the space complexity would be actually, if you see the big O of b, sorry, big O of 1 plus big O of b, then plus big O of 2b, and then in this way plus big O of bs, or sb, just to write it down in this way, which is nothing but big O of bs. Okay? Actually, in fact, I should not write, actually, if I write this plus, 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 that itself actually is wrong. Because after doing that, you are just forgetting that. It's not like you are storing that and again you are storing some more information. So actually, I should not even write this plus. So first time this, second time this, third time this. The only thing matters is the very last one. Max of that thing, right, max of that thing. And which is the last thing? Which is also known, which is the last thing? Okay, so let's proceed. So we got the very crucial part, we spent some time, and now the other part. So finding the shortest path, how many of you know with the cost? Until now we found the shortest path. How can you find the shortest path if the path cost is the same for each vertex? Yeah, like each node, everything has the same cost. Breath first search, that's the answer. Shortest path, because you are going through breath, like this. Breath first search or the iterative depending, both of that will give me the solution. Both actually, iterative depending and breath first. But breath first is the straightforward and simple, right? So, best solution you can get using a breath first search or iterative depending, but not depth first search. But now, if I assign some cost, and variable cost, not a fixed cost, then how will you find the least cost path? Dijkstra's algorithm. So, we will not talk about that Dijkstra's algorithm, but we will just talk about the algorithm. Okay, we will not tell his name or anything, we will just talk about the algorithm. How has it been done? So, whoever does not know about that algorithm, you will not get scared. And another reason for not talking about that is, we will see that it is not like kind of the end, there will be more steps coming with this searching. So, this is basically what we are doing. We are right now trying to, what is the next thing that we are going to search is the least expensive thing that you have tried until now. That is very much the idea, right? So, until now, because breadth first search, there was no cost involved, specific or defined cost. So, there are some defined algorithms. Right now, our task is uniform cost search is, there are different paths, right? I can go from here. I'll go to the path which is closest to me, and the closest thing I'll calculate from the root. From the root until now, whichever point is the closest, I'm going to go there first. Make sense? From the root, like, okay, from the root, whichever distance is the closest, I will go there. I will go there first. Closest meaning minimum cost. For example, I'll just give you a very, very basic example. So, you probably want to go to your hostel, to your dining room, dining hall. So, you from that our university gate, you came to the Pragya Bhavan. And from there, you found out you can go to the Atma Vikash or you can go to the Pragya Bhavan. Just think Atma Vikash is half mile away and Pragya Bhavan is 1 mile away. Where will you go first? You want to go to the dining hall. Where will you go first? Atma Vikash. Because Atma Vikash is right now closer. It might be a defined way, but doesn't matter because all you are trying to find, oh, wherever I can go right now, which is not very far from the main gate, I'll go there. Atma Vikash is probably closer, probably not, but you are going there. Though you are going away from your goal, but you don't care. You just go to the Atma Vikash and then you see, oh, Atma Vikash is not the correct idea, probably I should go to the Pragya Bhavan. You'll realize that later, but right now, as Atma Vikash is closer, you are going to the Atma Vikash first. That is the algorithm all about. So, you do not need to remember any particular person's name, anything. Just this is the very basic algorithm. Whatever things you can see, okay, this is the closest thing I can go, you just go there. Okay? So, this algorithm, as you can see, all this guy is going to do is this guy want to cut this thing, which is having the same weight of these other things. And before doing that, then it wants to come here. What is the difference? These guidelines are not very strict here. So, we'll go there. So, this is the idea. You finish a particular closer distance thing first, then before you go further down. Okay? So, again, as you can probably you can figure it out, this algorithm I'm talking, this algorithm is nothing but the same BFS. If I give that for this algorithm, all the costs are the same. Okay? There also, whatever node is closer to the root, you go there first before you go to the anything further. Here also the same, but only the difference is I am adding something which is the cost. Okay? How many of you do not know about the Dijkstra's algorithm? Shortest path. Dijkstra's algorithm, good. This is good. So, you do not need to know. But from this algorithm, you will learn just like that. And it would be actually good if you do not know that, it is good because you can connect other algorithms better. You can be connected, or you can understand the other algorithms better if you do not know. You do not need to make any complicated chart or anything. It is very straightforward algorithm, okay? So uniform search algorithm, so let's see. This is the tree. And this is the graph, and from there we can come up with the tree. The same tree, the tree did not get chance. But only thing added is the cost. Okay? So our start state is 0, then from there where will you go? So I have three things. From the 0 I can go to D, E and P. So I will go to P, the shortest. See, at the beginning whenever you are searching, you cannot see what are the things G is there after or not. You don't know anything. You just see, oh, where is my target? Oh, what is closer to me? You just go there. Is the following? Good. Okay. Now you go to the P. And once you go to the P, see the marking actually. Whatever is the current explore node, that means you are done with that particular node that are marked with the color. Whatever the circle, that means from that particular things you can go to that locations. You just remember there. You remember that, okay, I can go there, there, there. But you do not go there right now. Okay? So but you go to the P and you see that, okay, from the P you can come to go to the Q. But now from P should you go to the Q? Or now what you should do? From
P you can move into Q.
Yeah, yes.
And your destination is G.
You don't care about the destination. That is very important part. Don't care about the destination. You care about, but don't write now. It is like foggy, you cannot see anything. You, whatever the closer thing you can go, you just go there. Huh? Where do you go? From the P, where can I go actually? Let's see actually. From P, I can go to Q. And what is the cost? 15. And then the total cost from the root to Q would be 16. So I write it down, 16. But now where should I go? So I have a map and I'm kind of marking it, right? And I found out that, oh, this is a bad path. Next time I can go to the 16. But that is not the good thing. That is not the shortest. What is the shortest? D. So I'll go to from S to D. Okay? You always go to the path which is shortest. No, no, you always remember. See, at this time, you right now remember, you know that D is at 3, E is at 9, P is at 1, and Q is at 16. How did you come about the Q? Because you went to the P. If you are lucky and the P had directly path to the G, probably that would be very shorter, but it is not. But right now you are aware about the distance D, E, P, Q, and you find out the shortest out of this, which is that? The shortest path from the S to any particular node, what is that? D, which is the distance 3. And once you go D, then the fog has been removed little bit forward. You can see from the D, where can I go? Where can I go from the D? B, C and E. And see, from the D, the cost is, D to B is cost is 1. And already you have walked 3 miles. So you are just, for going to the B through this path, total distance would be 4 miles. So write the 4 here. So you are not writing 1 here, you are writing the 4. Because all the distance are measured from the source. So very good point. So he is telling that task is moving. Now go back to our earlier class. We are talking about a model. You have a paper. Agent is always thinking. In this whole thing we are talking about a model. So this is defined from the real world, remember? I have a model and I'm just finding, okay, what path I should follow. In reality, whenever I try to follow, there might be some other issues, the cost I'm seeing that might not match, many things can happen. So everything is a planning stage. Okay? So everything is in planning, you're just planning. Okay? The whole thing is not searching, it is called planning. It is a planning agenda, all you are doing is planning. No action, you are just not taking out the notebook and thinking. Right? That is the idea, not working anything, just thinking. No, the computer theoreticians like to think. You know the one thing, right? There is a joke, a very optimal joke, that if you see that the computer theoreticians, that how can you move these three rocks from here to there? They will do the math and many things, they will think for the whole day and think, and they will look, these three moved rocks cannot be moved. That's what they do. Which is a very optimal thing to do. If you can prove it, that it cannot be moved, then you do not need to try and do all those things. So thinking is good, as our agent is doing the same thing, he's thinking. Not doing anything, it's just thinking. It's just right now planning, oh, I want to go to the GE, this is my target in my life, how can I go? Okay, and whoever knows that algorithm shortest path still follow, because the connection will come on, keep on adding, as you can see, DFS, BFS, then probably you have added, learned the new thing, iterative depending. In this way, this is not the end, this is kind of the beginning, there will be more stuffs coming. Okay, so from there, where do we go? B. And when I go to the B, something else exposed to me, which is A. So I found out the 6. Now where should I go? What are the options I have right now for going? A, C, E, E, Q. These are the places I can go. Where should I go? E. Because this E is the closest 5, so I go there. When I go E, I found out there are 2 other paths, I go there. Which one is the shortest? From there? B to A. What is the total cost from the S? 6. Good. Now next, where I go? See, you can just need to look into these things, the circles, because circles are the only things there you can go right now. So where can you go? See the circle and see the weight. Where? E to R, because the cost is 7. From R you can go to the F. Right? And right now where should I go? R to F. And from F you can go to location. Where should you go? S to E, because that is a 9, and you can go 17, 11 and all other costs. What next? F to G. Okay, and found out the final solution. What?
V9.
S to E, because that is 9, it is 9, the cheapest one. At this level, 8 and 9, so eight, the 9 is the cheapest of the 8. Huh? Oh, you got the, so very good point. So you got the G before, but you do not stop there. You do not tell that G is the correct path until you fetch it. Until you color it. Why is that? Because there is a very good point actually. Why do not I, once I get the F, why still I want to go back to the E? That is the question, right? From the F, because I know already that I can go to C and G. I already know I can go to G. Should not I just go to G? Huh? Next. So yes, so I'm not having the number, but it might happen. I still want to go to the E, because I might have a, from the E, I might have a 0.5 path to Z. I don't know. Right? I might have. So that's why I do not care I found it or not. As long as I'm not picking it, the next thing, that time, until that time I'll not select the G. Make sense? It is actual?
Is it actually just algorithm or modified?
Big stress. The same algorithm. There also you have to do the same thing. There also the same thing.
After insert type,
No, no, the algorithm is same. You check it. So there also you need to be very, very important that if you find a path. So for example, I'll just give you a very quick idea of this one. So that you have a path directly to the G, the cost is 10, and you have a path A and B, 1 and 1. Which path should you choose? Huh? S A G, not S G. Though at the beginning, whenever you are going to the S, you can see the G. You can see the G, but you don't do anything. You just tell, oh no, I want to go to the shortest first. As you can see, oh yes, literally from the A, there is a shorter path to the G. So even though I'm finding the G at this level, I still go to the E first. At this level, from the 8, I already found out I can go to C and G, but still I don't go to the G, I go to E. And then I see, oh, E, I can go to two other different locations which are higher. So I just look into the value. If there is a 9.5, I would go there first before going to the G. So I see, okay, the next one is higher is the G, so I go there and found, okay, I declared, okay, this is the best path. Control levels is kind of, it is this basic idea that, okay, we are just going, okay, just, it is just telling, it's not much, it's just telling that, see, all the nodes from 1 to 6 are yellow, it's just telling that all those things are in the same level. You covered those before you access anything in this green level. Just the weights. As you can see, there are different levels, there are different depth, but still I'm going to much deeper because the cost is less. That's it. Every node
has been reached in the minimal cost.
Yes. Okay. Okay. So we'll talk about this after lunch. So when will you come? Huh? After? After two? No, no, no. Because no, I want to get my time. See, if other, so we'll start at 2 and from there we'll go until 3. Today, right, so then that would make my 2 hours complete. Okay? Huh? No, it won't, because we started a little bit late. Okay, if we can finish early, we'll do. But let's meet at 2 and from the 2 we'll go to until 3. I'll try to send an email to other professors so that they'll give you one time.